Welcome to the Peachtree Morning Show by DCI. It's a wise way to start the day. Hope you enjoy.
Hi, this is Geshe Michael Roach. Welcome back to the Peachtree Morning Show. And I'm so excited today to have such amazing guests from around the world. First, we have Emily Chen. Raise your hand.
Hi.
Taipei, right? Taiwan.
Taichung, sorry.
In the middle of Taiwan. And she's amazing Diamond X teacher. She's been 10 times to the Sedona College of International Management, which is a perfect record. And she now gives Diamond X public talks and study groups all over her country. And it's amazing. And thank you very much for being with us. And she's been doing DCI work almost 10 years now. And thank you for that. And you and your partner are very important for all of our work in Asia. And thank you for that, Gibson, right?
Yeah.
And Alex Rowland is from Colorado, United States. She's also has come to all the Sedona College terms, 10 terms. She's a real estate investor. And you know, if you need a place to stay, just talk to her. She has houses everywhere. And she's also a yoga instructor, and she's gonna be part of the new Yoga Studies Institute platform, which I think is rolling out in the next week or two, and we'll let you know more about that. So let's get going, Emily. What day is it, by the way?
June the 29th.
Okay, cool, almost July.
Yes.
And do you have a question for us, and where is it from?
Okay, yes. Today I have a question. It's from gentleman Sam in Taiwan. Let me play it for you.
Good morning, Geshe-la and teachers. I'm Sam from Taiwan. I'm there in the C system and doing this just 3 months. I'm very lucky. There are some good C's opening. Therefore, I want to help more people learn this system. However, they always get used to the old thinking ways. So besides the pain and emptiness, if they are more measured, could help myself constantly supporting the objective of life. Thank you.
Emily, you have to explain this question.
Okay, so Sam is studying the Diamond Cutter C system for 3 months, and he's been getting some results, so he's very excited to share the principle with his friend. However, he find out like a lot of his friends fall back to the old way thinking. So his question is, besides sharing pain and emptiness, is there a way so he can constantly help his friend and himself to use the system more and then to get the objective result they desire in their life?
So I have I'm gonna ask Alex to start, and I'll make the question like this. What do you think is the seeds to see people around you? They hear about the seed system, they think, oh, maybe I will try it, and they try it for a while, and then suddenly they go back to old things that don't really work all the time. So what's the seed for me to see that?
I think that the seed to see that would be not practicing the new system really steadily yourself. Or maybe there's other ways that you're not sticking with a steady plan that you have. For instance, if you were planning on exercising, doing your yoga 5 days a week, and then you only did it once, that inconsistency would maybe plant that kind of a seed. What do you think?
Yeah. I'm gonna ask Emily, what do you think? Do you know Sam from before?
Yes, I've been working with him for a couple of weeks. Yes.
Okay, cool. So I'll tell you my own example. Like I'm involved with many projects, many businesses, and sometimes I catch myself that I'm thinking the old way, you know. Actually, very often I check myself. Very often I found out I'm just thinking the old way, you know? So let's say I have a problem with somebody working with me and I have a problem with them. Then I will start to blame it on them And I will start to think of many different ways I can solve the problem. But actually, I should just stop doing what they're doing myself, right? But I can't remember that. So how to remember, Emily? What will you tell? What will you tell the founder of the seed system who cannot remember the seed system?
I can tell myself because I always did this a lot. I constantly forget, and so. But I find out there's a good way, a good method to help me is the six times books, because like we all know like. Once you done once, you grow a habit of doing the same thing over and over again. And before we learn this system, it's been so many years we are doing things in the old way. So it's really hard and it takes time to get rid of the old habit. So for me personally, I really like the method, the six times books, which means like you stop, you pause yourself six times during the day, and then you reflect yourself. What I'm doing right now, am I thinking about a seed? Am I using the fourth step to help others? So you kind of like pop this question, and then you readjust how you do things and how you think. And I think this method is really helping me, at least if I'm writing it, at least help me six times a day, other than just let time pass and then at the end, and then I didn't do anything like according to C system.
So I'm gonna ask Alex, I wanna go deeper with you, okay? I'm not gonna let you relax and give a normal answer. So people who learned, people who came to the SCIM college, you can hear people say, well, let's say, I don't know, we have income problem, right? Then we will say, I'm gonna do this thing, and this thing, and and then I will also plant a seed. I will also plant a seed, you know. But I heard this new DCI talk. People say shallow cause and deep cause do together. It's okay, you know. What do you think about that?
I think that we do need to do both together, and we can start thinking about first planting the seed. Start with what your seed planting plan is going to be. What is your four-step plan going to be? And really get that solid and then going. And then we'll still use the shallow causes or the old ways, because for now, anyway, I need them. And but I don't know what's going to work. I don't know if calling up old clients is going to get some new business going, or, you know, should I start an email campaign? I don't know which of those is going to work unless I planted the seeds for it already from the beginning. So I would say putting the seed plan together, then going about your business, and you don't have to worry about the results because you already planted them.
Okay, so you're saying a little bit of both. Okay, I have some experts in the room here.
Okay.
I'm at the Sedona College today because we're working on other things. Okay, they are not dressed business dress, I'm sorry. There are some hippies I found on the street. We have Seiji, who works for DCI headquarters, Noor Ibrahim, and Tim Lohenhout, who's the director of ACI. What do you guys think? We don't have much time probably, right? Oh, go ahead. Let's start with Seiji. What if we see people who start with the seed system, but then they lose it and they go back to their old habits?
Well, I would say...
Wait, you can take your mask off to answer.
Okay. So I would say, if you already have experience with being successful with seeds, then go for something a little bit more challenging. I find that often you leave things because they don't give you results that you really want. So after you have experience having success with one or two, then go for something that you really want. And that will, I think, in myself, at least it will keep me motivated and say, okay, so now I'm going for the real thing. In my case, it was, I wanted to get my dream job. I said, this is really something that if I get, I'll be happy. So I think that would be my advice.
Okay, put your mask back on. Noor.
So I think one important our own experience. For example, if I tried four steps, I shared the four steps with others, but I applied first in my life. So I matched practice with sharing. For me, I think it planted good seed to see people around us inspired by our own example and also getting the information, the right information.
Tim Lohenhauer.
You know,
talk loud.
For me, I oftentimes, I'll forget. I'll have something to do, I'll have a problem, and immediately I'm off, trying to solve it without thinking of the deeper cause for it. So what I oftentimes try to do is, for me to have those seeds to remember, because you have to interrupt. For me, it's about an interruption of, all right, so if I need to interrupt my old thinking, how do I plant the seeds to help other people? So what I try to do with my friends, when we're having things go on and we listen to each other, it's like, oh, Seiji, that's really interesting. And then I try to help him go there with the, so then when I coffee meditate, I said, okay, I helped him take his mind there. So then he would plant the seed. So then when I coffee meditate, I then dedicate that. So I will have that awareness to come back to it when I'm trying to solve a problem.
Cool. I'm going to ask you guys another question, Alex and Emily. So sometimes we feel shy to try the seed system if we're new, right? Because our family members don't like it. The family members say, oh, that's crazy, that's not gonna work, What can we do then? What do you guys think? Emily, what do you think? So family member says, look, I like those people, you learn the seed system, it's very nice, but it's not really practical.
Yes. I find out it's really good to have a partner so you can discuss the system with and you can encourage with each other. For me, take me for example, sometimes I also have the tendency to fall back into old way and then I forget to use the C system, but luckily sometimes my partner Gibson will remind me. So he will say do you talking about C? Are you using the system? So he's a very good place on this. And it really helped me to keep thinking. So I would say for ourselves, we can also find this kind of partner and then to encourage them and then to remind them or to share the experience or the thinking we have with each other.
So Alex, what do you do if you feel like the whole Colorado state, all the people are kind of discouraging you from doing the seed system? What will you do about it?
Well, I will keep going because
I know that you're so stubborn.
I'm going to be very stubborn. And I'm also going to try to make sure that I'm listening to other people's ideas. That I'm not criticizing new ideas that I hear, that I try to be more open to the things that people are trying in their lives. I don't want to get narrow-minded because that's going to plant a seed for people to be narrow-minded when I talk about something. My daughter was particularly in the beginning, I don't think she was very interested in what I was doing. She's 26, 27 now, I think. And then she wrote me an email recently and said, Mom, I used what you told me at work when my boss was yelling at me. And it really worked.
Boss in the kitchen.
She used it with the yelling boss. And then her boss was nicer the next day. And she wrote me a thank you email. So that was really nice. I think being patient and being stubborn.
That's cool. How are we doing on time, Seiji?
We have 44 seconds.
We have how much?
40 seconds.
We gotta have three ideas for Sam. Okay, Emily, you wanna start? Give me one practical suggestion for Sam, and then I'm gonna ask Alex.
Okay, so for me, my practical tips is to support others yourself. So find a partner and then support each other and encourage each other to think at least one day, pick up one thing to think. What is the emphasis on this? And am I using the system to plant the necessary seed for me to achieve my goal?
Alex? What's your practical suggestion?
My practical suggestion is making sure that you have some type of a study group so that you're thinking about it more often. I'm going to give two. Also, coffee meditation every night will help you remember, which will help the people around you remember.
You can join the Taijong Reading Club, Sam. What's my I tell you a suggestion in my life is it's possible that the old method of doing something is completely wrong, and it's very fun. Sam, go to the bookstore, the old bookstore, and buy the old science magazine, which is 20 years old or 30 years old. And there's not one thing in there which is true. Everything in that magazine is false now. But at the time, it was the belief of the whole world, you know? So I think it's a very good exercise. Go to the bookstore, read the old science books, at least 20 years old, and everything in the book is wrong. So maybe 20 years from now, all of our normal ideas will be wrong. I think so. Okay. All right. I'm going to ask these guys to stay here for Wednesday. Okay. Can you come back on Wednesday?
I need to play a video, right, for the question for
Tuesday. Yeah. Let's see what's the question for Tuesday.
This is Beatrice from Shanghai. Because I have applied for the 7th level DCI teaching in Shanghai in June this year, but now I'm really worried about if our schedule will be impacted on by the coronavirus. So could you tell us what we can do to make sure our teaching can be held on time? Thank you so much.
That's Beatrice from Taiwan, I believe.
Okay, that's a tough question for tomorrow. Who's going to help tomorrow?
Tomorrow is going to be Janice and Sunny.
Oh, Janice and Sunny. Singapore and there's a weird place called Colorado. Okay.
Yes.
Emily has one more thing, I think.
Okay.
Yes. We really love to receive all the questions from around the world. So we encourage, don't be shy to share your question. Your question may help others. So 30 seconds vertical selfie style, send to cquestion@diamondcutterinstitute.com.
Okay. And don't forget to send in your 1 hour Spotify playlist to musicmix@diamondcutterinstitute.com. And we really like different countries' music, okay? So please send in your music. Alex's partner is a great musician, and we play together in Taiwan, right? Yeah.
Yes.
Okay, cool. In other countries. All right, so I'll see you guys on Wednesday.
Okay. Yes. See you on Wednesday. Thank you, Geshe Michael. Thank you, Emily.
Thanks for coming to Peachtree. It was a long swim from Taiwan.
Thank you, Geshe. Thank you, Alex. Bye.
Bye.
Thanks for watching today's Peachtree Morning Show. See you next time.